Welcome to this video on the topic of specific heat capacity. The temperature of a substance is affected by three main things: its mass, the type of material, i.e. a conductor or insulator, and the amount of energy transferred to a thermal store. Energy is transferred to and from thermal stores by heating. This then affects the temperature of a substance or system. A bigger mass requires more energy to heat it to a specific temperature in a certain amount of time than a smaller one. For example, water filled to the top of a large pot will take longer to boil than a full, smaller one. Conductors such as steel transfer heat better than insulators such as wood. The more energy transferred to a substance, the hotter it will become. For example, a radiator turned up to its maximum will heat up the air much more than one on a low setting. Every substance has its own specific heat capacity. This is the energy required per unit mass per unit temperature increase. It has a symbol lowercase c and units joules per kilogram per Kelvin or joules per kilogram per degree Celsius. Its equation is delta E, the change in thermal energy in joules, divided by m, the mass in kilograms, times delta theta, the change in temperature in degrees Celsius or Kelvin. Delta just means change in, so it doesn't matter whether the temperature is given in Celsius or Kelvin, because the change in either of those scales is the same. To know which unit to use, look at what units the temperature has been given in the question. The specific heat capacity is the property of a substance which has been scientifically agreed upon through thorough experiments. Here are a few examples. Copper has a lower specific heat capacity than aluminium, which is lower than water. The lower the specific heat capacity, the quicker a substance heats up and cools down, and vice versa. All three materials are thermal conductors. However, for the same amount of energy supplied, copper will heat up by a larger amount. For example, if we have 5,000 joules of energy supplied to 1 kilogram of all three substances, copper will increase by 12.8 degrees, aluminium by 5.5, and water by only 1.2. You'll not need to memorize the specific heat capacity of any substance for your exam. You'll always be given the value in the question or asked to calculate it. Let's go through an example of using the specific heat capacity equation. In one day, 310 kilograms of water is pumped through a solar panel. There is 18 megajoules of energy incident on the solar panel during the day and the water rises to 32 degrees C. The specific heat capacity of water is 4,200 joules per kilogram per degree C. Calculate the initial temperature of the water for 4 marks. First, we can see what variables have been given in the question. We have the mass, the energy, the final temperature, and the specific heat capacity. Next, write down the specific heat capacity equation. We need to rearrange this for delta theta, the change in temperature. Remember, delta theta is the final temperature minus the initial temperature. This is theta F minus theta I, worth 1 mark. The question asks for the initial temperature, theta I. Rearranging for this gives theta I equals theta F minus delta E over mc. This gives a second mark. Now we need to substitute in the values for the third mark. Remember that the prefix capital M means mega or 10 to the power of 6. Putting this in your calculator should give you 18.175 or 18 degrees Celsius to two significant figures. This is the fourth and final mark. Now we need to do a couple of checks. The question states that the temperature rises to 32 degrees, so we need an answer lower than 32, which is what we have, so that makes sense. Also, notice they've said water, which has a freezing point of 0 degrees, so we're not expecting a negative temperature either. Always show you're working clearly by writing all equations out in full. In reality, the actual increase in temperature may not be as high as this since energy is lost to the surroundings. You must be confident in rearranging equations to get full marks in all calculation questions. To summarise, the definition of specific heat capacity is the energy required per unit mass per unit temperature increase. This is defined by the equation C equals delta E over m times delta theta. You will be expected to memorise this equation for your exam. This means a substance with a low specific heat capacity will heat up and cool down quickly, and vice versa. This temperature difference can be in Kelvin or degrees Celsius, since the difference between two temperatures on both scales is the same. Every substance has its own specific heat capacity, which you will not be expected to remember. However, you must be able to use the value in calculations and interpret it. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.